something about it. I feel like it's...
Still alive, I see. Something tells me that eyesore on the horizon is your doing. How'd you manage that?
It's a long story. One that I'd rather only tell once.
Right. All hands on deck, then.
Is this everyone? As I'm sure you've all guessed, the crystal which now commands the eastern skies was summoned by Ultima. He called it Origin. Though the significance of that name is as yet unclear.
What does it matter what it's called? Its emergence tore Twinside asunder and wiped my homeland from the map.
Mention of the Dominion spires can be found in the oldest of Valisthian records. But to the best of my knowledge, none provide any hint as to their true nature. That they would prove the horns of some slumbering demon. Well,
the Dominion's demise was at least quick. Elsewhere, the Republican army cannot hope to contain the chaos engulfing Randalar. Canva is in flames, and the Empire.
Our allies are crying out for answers. I've sent the Cursebreakers to give them what assurances we can, but right now that amounts to fuck all.
They wouldn't be able to stop what the skies have started in any case. People here and across the realm grow sicker with every passing day.
Could it be that this new Mother Crystal is like the others? That it draws upon the land's ether? It certainly looked that way, from stone here.
If that were true, it would explain the hastening spread of the Blight since the Crystal's appearance. Would it not?
And as the land's ether slowly rises to the surface, it pools, corrupting all who cannot channel its energies. Arcane above, ether floods below, and in the middle, here we languish, hopelessly entrapped.
It's all right. When we faced him at Stonehere, Ultima told us his true power quickens in the halls of Origin. Needless to say, we cannot allow that to continue. If we are to stop him, we will have to find a way into the crystal.
How are we going to manage that then? He's up in the sky. And fast as she is, the Enterprise can't fly.
It's a lot to take in, and I reckon we'd all benefit from some time to clear our heads. The answer will come to us. Don't you worry. Ain't that right, Clive?
Right. That's right.
Well, go on then. Bugger off. Same goes for you, Clive. You won't solve anything like this. Trust me. Go and get some fresh air, eh?
Thank you. Joshua seemed upset. Ultima may have created us, but he doesn't make us who we are. Only we can do that. And if he would have us fight for our survival, so be it. It's what we've been doing all along.
Much like Ultima himself, it would seem. His new world being naught but a means to survive. And so, we must contend to decide which of us shall inherit the land. Should Ultima prevail, it will mean death for us all. Of that, we can be certain. But even should he fail, what world awaits us? A withered, godless place, where our newfound freedom will most like prove a chain in itself.
Well, that may be, but a chain can always be broken. As long as one has the will to break it, it won't be easy. It may take generations, centuries of suffering. And that is if everyone plays their part. But it will happen. And when it does, it will be on our terms. That is the world that awaits us.
Indeed. And what better world could one wish for?
But first, we have to reach that crystal.
Then it's a good thing I have wings.
You can barely stand, let alone fly. And only the Founder knows what horrors await in those skies. You certain about this?
Am I certain? I am the Phoenix. I will do what I must. This is our fight. Remember.
All right. I yield. But only what you must, yes? I'm still your sworn shield.
That you are.
And what of my wings? Lest you forget, you go to stand against a god. I would not have you succumb to fatigue before the fight begins. Ifrit, your brother mentioned that some few of the dominants who had lost their power to you were still able to prime. Is that true?
It is. Their icons no longer submitted to their will.
Then mine will have to be stronger. That you both might save your strength for the battle to come.
You don't have to do this.
If you do, there's a chance you might lose all you have left.
And what have I but regret? My life ended in the Dominion. I fear death no more. Besides, I would have words with Ultima. He has much to answer for.
We are in your debt, Dion.
We can speak of debts when this is over.
Speaks like a man who knows he's not coming back. And has come to terms with that.
That doesn't mean that we have to, does it, Kyfe?
Time to talk to Jill. I only hope she understands.
come to wish on a star.
That might not be such a bad idea. This is it, Jill. You know what I have to do. Why I have to do it. There's no turning back now. This is where our journey was leading us. Where it will end, for better or worse.
I could pray to Metia for you. But you'll be all right, won't you, Clive? You always are.
I did promise we'd watch the moon together.
I'll be waiting.
It's almost time. Better make sure I haven't forgotten anything.
Clive, if you see my dad up there, tell him we were right to leave his legacy with you.
Tell him he'll be in the front row. There's no way he'd miss this. Well, behave yourself, Mitt.
We'll see.
So, you're in charge now, Gav.
And what does Taya have to say about that? Come back before she finds out, eh?
Thank you, Yote. I'm sorry.
Your Grace, I shall pray for your safe return.
That's kind of you, but you should pray he took his medicine. I didn't spend all night grinding herbs for his lordship to leave them on his nightstand. Again.
You needn't fear, Lady Taya. And thank you.
See that your brother comes back in one piece. Or, at most, two. Any more and you can heal him yourself.
I'll keep that in mind.
Well, there's nothing to say that hasn't already been said. But that's never stopped me before. So just you do what needs doing. And don't worry about us.
We'll do our best, Uncle.
That'll be well.
If that is all?
Not quite. Jill.
It's time, isn't it?
It is. Take care of him. Take care of her too, boy.
Don't forget, Clive. We all choose our own path. Believe in yours. I do.
I'll be back. I promise. I love you, Jill.
I know. I love you too.
We have a god to kill.
Here they come. Hold on, Joshua.
Already am.
To make us a way in.
was here that we slumbered. Here that we waited for centuries, clinging to our decrepit shell, for fear that we might have need of it once again. But you have come at last. And now we shall be truly complete.
Well? There's three of us, and one of him. Let's make it count.
We will show you what it means to suffer.
And you will not claim us! Ever!
surrendered, this unpleasantness could have been avoided.
Not for acceptance. Only forgiveness!
No.
Did I mention you look terrible?
That makes two of us.
Oh, I'll be all right.
And Dion. Take my hand.
I told you, I'll be...
Come on.
Thank you.
press on.
Always. Did what he had to do.
And it's time we did the same. Should we stop?
Not because of a cough. No, I think we're past that, Clive.
I suppose we are.
So empty. We're close, aren't we?
It seems that way. But I don't want to think what could be waiting for us in there.
Then think instead of those waiting for us at home.
This is the Nexus, a wellspring of life, yours and ours, as we watch the world stumble slowly to its dark end. It was here we pledged a new beginning, and now, with the ether we have harvested, I shall raise my kin from their eternal slumber, that together we may usher in a new age of reason.
This was never about creation, only self-preservation. You condemned an entire world so that you alone might escape death.
Alone. Him. Alone. Clive. I think I understand. He...
They sacrificed their flesh to become beating hearts of crystal that pumped the land's lifeblood from the depths of the earth unto this very chamber. And thus would they labor still, long after their work was done, had you not set them free.
You meant for us to destroy the Mother Crystals. It's what you wanted all along.
You have our gratitude, Muthos. In this you have served us well. You have both served us well. Welcome home, brother.
It was me, but it
wasn't my grasp that grew weaker. It was theirs that grew stronger.
Joshua! No!
And now, we can become one.
Possessed of the destructive flames of Ifrit and the healing flames of the Phoenix. This, I once believed, would be Ultima's true form. But I was wrong. I see it now. Why you will never become Ultima's vessel.
I don't care. Just hold on.
Listen to me, Clive. Remember the murals? People once knew that Ultima was their god. That he created them. And they worshipped him, prayed to him, looked to him for guidance. In vain. In vain. For he did not listen, did not acknowledge our will. And so we strayed from his path to forge one of our own. So absorbed was he in his own desires, so driven by his own will alone, that he shunned the one thing that could have made him truly powerful. Faith. The same faith people now place in you. Faith that you will fulfill their dream, Sid's dream, of creating a better world for us. Faith that you will follow in Father's footsteps and save those who need saving most. Faith that you will answer Jill's plea to save yourself. The difference is, Clive, that you chose to listen, and that is what has steeled our bonds. Bonds that helped you stand firm when Ultima's pull was at its strongest. His power may be absolute, but so is ours, and so will yours be. My light in your heart. Not even a god might stop us.
Joshua! Don't do it, you're...
Enough, Clive. My body is too far gone. If the wound does not take me, the curse will.
Thank you. open your eyes! Open your eyes, damn you! Why did you do this? Joshua! Joshua!
And thus does the final piece fall into place. The incantation primed, but one task remains: to empty the vessel.
Still here.
As we always have, and always will. On this, my sword I swear, to shield the Firebird's flame forevermore.
Force feeds these flames. I sense more here than mere will. Is this Logos? Have you truly become free? No, I forbid it.
You are not a god. You are but flesh and bone. You are not one of us.
yours. Our flames are our own, and they burn as one!
Have you learned nothing? Damned is the slave who would turn the scourge upon his master!
From the moment the Blight exposed what you were, weak, you conceived us to prove otherwise. But the result shook you to the core. For in us you saw yourself, and realized we had the potential to be more than you could ever be. And so you turned your back on your creation, your back on the world, like the coward you are.
You think you know me? You know nothing, Logos. Nothing. Bathed in light, I stand above you, my rebirth complete. And you, for your defiance, shall pay the proper price. An eternity of anguish.
Anguish. Pain. Suffering. You have known none of these. But we have. So we know what they grant. They bring us together. And that makes...
chance, my boy!
No, mine is the altar at which you pray. Mine are the eyes that look down upon you all.
And yet still you cannot see. You are no better than us. We are one and the same.
We are not the same!
No!
only fantasy here is yours. And we shall be its final witness.
No!
I said... don't know. But I doubt it will be pretty. A sorry tale of sin and suffering, hardship and pain.
And it was for this that you fought so fiercely? Why?
It's who we are. We fight. We survive. We endure. We don't need a reason. We are imperfect creatures. When we stumble, we reach for a shoulder to lean on. When we fall, we stand back up. We see the horizon, ever out of reach, and still we march on. Certain the answers lie just beyond it. Because that is our way.
Congratulations. Relish this victory, knowing that you have but delayed the inevitable. Your world is already dead. May you enjoy an eternity on its blackened heart.
seems Ultima's power was too great for this vessel all along. For while I have it, perhaps I can use it to set things right. And see Ultima's legacy. Bearers, dominance, crystals, magic. Consigned to the flames. Even if it means the end of me.
You the most beautiful thing.
He is, isn't he? What are you gonna call him?
Let me see. Oh, Reed, little one. Got a smile for your Uncle Gav.
Not so loud, you bird.
What? I was only...
Shh! You're scaring him.
It's all right.
If you need a rest, I can take him.
I'll hold you to that.
The world's yours now. Yours to do with as you please. That's what Sid wanted. That's what they both wanted.
Did our journey end?